basically like get a pallet, take it apart, and then use it as needed, pretty much, you know. Then I get a hammer and a chisel and I split it, make different sizes, different shapes and stuff, you know. Whatever I can find. I mean, one man's trash is another man's treasure. It's a real shit. But yeah, this frame's made from recycled pallets and stuff that I split up that you saw earlier or whatever. Then I burn the wood a little, put resin. It's the money maker right here, baby. OG Jigsaw. It's like the tool I use the most. So. And then, this is a recycled t-shirt. Cut that up. Made a frame for it. Put resin on top. Now, anything I get a hold of, it doesn't have to be a picture necessarily.
Wow, so this is a t-shirt?
Yeah.
I would have never heard of it. You can't even tell. So what did you hit that? You stretched it?
I just spray glued it to a piece of wood.
Uh-huh.
And cut around it. Like all the little scrap edges and shit.
Uh-huh.
And made a frame for it. Parking sign.
Pay him now.
Pay me now. So there's all these signs in downtown LA and Venice all the time. It fell off a pole, I don't know how. And I just cut it up and do my thing, you know? Got a hip hop collage. I like collages. I made this one with broken records and a lot of beat swap me photos too. That was an event in Chinatown I used to be cracking. If y'all didn't go to that, you missed out. Living Legends pictures. I shot Black Star, so there's quality right there. There's most def. Did a Deltron show, so there's Delta Funky Homo Sapien. So, you know, I keep it hip hop. That's what I grew up listening to, so that's my specialty. Yeah, people ask me about this one a lot. This is downtown LA. I had a, climb up like halfway up the fence and put the camera in a barbed wire without getting cut. And this is made with recycled wood and the scrap pallets. I burned it with a torch, put resin on it.
So how long did a piece like this take you?
Start to finish, like 3 hours. So I gotta cut everything, put resin, let the resin dry, put more. So that's the longest shit, is like waiting for the resin to dry. But actually cutting all the shit out, it only takes like a half hour, an hour. And I gotta wait for the spray paint to dry. So it's a bunch of layers, you know what I'm saying? That's what people don't understand sometimes. It's like,
so what history is in this piece?
You got Venice Beach right here. This is Vernon. Never been caught right there. Big ass rollers. That shit's been there for years. This is probably in 09. LA River shot down here. 110 freeway right here. More under the bridge near the LA River and the train tracks. Freeway killer crash right there. He's still up. This is a Search Forever production back in the day when he died. So yeah, it's like a lot of graffiti history. A lot of shit's gone or buffed. Search sticker, you know? One of the illest writers in LA. He's probably put up the most stickers out of anybody.
Legend.
Right? And then everything else is just random shit I come across that people give me. One of my friends used to work at a wine distributing place. So they got me a couple boxes. So I made this out of it.
How deep is your network to like people that own stores that throw out stuff?
It's just who you know, man. Like, you gotta ask and like shoot the shit with them, you know? Like, don't be shy. And so people know I make art out of recycled stuff, so it gets around that. Hey, if I got something, people like hold it for me, or they'll give me an idea, or they'll like tell me where it's at. So I was like, fuck it, it's wood. Anything wood, I'll use it. My neighbors be dropping shit off sometimes. I'm like, hey, y'all gotta kick back. Same junkyard and shit, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like,
what'd you put the photo on?
Plywood.
Plywood? Yeah, because I bought one of these pieces similar to this.
Yeah, it's plywood, and I beat up the edges. Spray paint them. Because I don't know. You see a lot of art is just always perfectly square or rectangle. Get tired of that shit.
Yeah, that's what's unique a lot about a lot of your stuff. It has this like this unwritten beauty to it. That's what I like about it. You know, it's raw.
Yeah, this is like different because like you go to art galleries and art shows, you see the same shit over and over and over. Fucking bowls of fruit and shit.
And where does your you know the origin of your name? See, what does that mean?
It means to share. It's Arabic. My mom got it out of a baby book. I don't know why, but it is what it is. So that's my goal, is to share my art and my photos with people, you know? So I try to live up to that shit.
That's dope. Do you look at the object first and then get an idea off that, or is it...
I don't know.
What's your process?
I don't really have a process, like... I repeat it one, you know, like, I'll get an idea, and then if I got the materials to make it, I'll make it. If not, I'll, like, do what I gotta do. But most of the time, it starts with a photo, but before the photo is an idea of the photo. You gotta have, like, an idea of the photo in your head before you take it. And I won't be happy until, like, what's in my head is in the camera, you know what I'm saying? So, once I get the photo printed, then I gotta like figure out what I'm gonna put it on. Am I gonna make a collage? Am I gonna just make a frame for it? It just always varies, you know? And I try not to like be repetitive and make the same shit over and over, you know? So everything's pretty much unique and custom. And it's just like, just try to be different, you know? You see some shit, you're like, oh, that's mass produced. I don't want that shit. Or, looks like you could buy it at Michael's or something. I'm like, nah. I like something like people are going to hang on to, you know what I'm saying? Or, like, be proud to have or, like, show off to other people.
Where'd you get this?
Found it. Rialto.
Was just on the street?
Yeah, it was tipped over and, like, weeds were growing around it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's what I said. It was like, this is money right there, bro. So, put on my little work vest I got from 99 Cent Store, make it look like I'm doing something. Threw that shit in the truck, took it home, cleaned it off, cleaned the inside real good. I mean, you can put whatever you want on the inside.
This was filled with weeds when you first found it?
It was like dirt, cobwebs and shit. So I had to wash it out. I took it to an event last Sunday. This is pretty much all blank. Shout out to all the people that have been putting stickers on it, tagging on it. So yeah, it's like a lot of street art photos. Yeah, my homie Pomona works at a record store, so he showed me these. A bunch of old warped records are all scratched up and shit. They couldn't do nothing with them. He didn't want to throw them away, so he gave them to me. So this shit ends up in a collage like this, you know? These are all photos I've taken over the years. Different shows. Beast Swami. More Beast Swami. DJ Premier right there. I was on stage with Kara this morning once. I just try to be as original as I can and just use all the stuff I got already, you know? So I got all these images. People like collages. And I try to, like, have a theme. Like, this one's mostly music, so I'm trying to do something different, you know? Something people can identify with.
Do you feel like you'll ever run out of original material as far as photographs?
Nah.
Nah? Really?
I got thousands.
You got them? Wow.
Thousands of photos, bro. I got shit I haven't even printed out yet. So. I'm always taking new ones too, so it's like, it's never ending, you know what I mean?
When did you first discover, you'd say, one of the facets of hip hop? What turned you out? What was your introduction?
Shit, my older brother, he was always banging tapes. Shit. He was into gangster rap, so of course, like Ice Cube growing up, N.W.A., Eazy-E.
You remember the first time you ever heard? What was the first hip hop song you heard?
Probably Rapper's Delight. That's the one I remember.
Rapper's Delight?
Yep. the message. But my mom's always had records playing, so like I grew up on like Prince, Isley Brothers, Rick James, you know, the usual, you know. But I just always liked hip hop from an early age. I always listened to it, like K-Day back in the day. Fucking Friday Night Flavors, all that shit back in the day, Wake Up Show. And then when I got to high school, I started going to shows more. And then one of my homeboys, he was a breakdancer. He introduced me to Unity back in the day. I don't know if you know about that, but Google that shit. Know your history. That was my first concert, and ever since then, I was turned out. Hip hop is like part of life now, you know? It's like the soundtrack to all my art.
What did you originally attach yourself to or participate in?
Yeah, I used to like scratch my mom's records up. She got pissed at that, so I had to find something else to do. So I dabbled in graffiti a little. Couldn't really draw that much, so I was like, gotta find something else to like contribute to the culture, you know? So started like documenting. So that's like my way to, you know, like giving back. Cause like go to all these shows, like you want to have memories of them, you know what I'm saying? So pretty much like a lot of people I ended up listening to as a kid, when I started getting older, I started shooting with them or going backstage and meeting them and shit. It was crazy. Like, it was real weird. Like, everything came on like 180. Like, listening to your heroes and then seeing them in person and sometimes doing business with them. Shit, now I'm publishing a book because I was just hanging around, you know? So, Micah 9 Freestyle Fellowship, OG in the rap game. So, basically, Abstract Root got me in being his photographer for his local shows. This is back in 07, 08, 09. And then I would just follow him around, take pictures and shit. And then like about 20 years later, I ended up getting published in their book just from hanging out with him. It's a little temple back in the day, just hanging out smoking blunts. New Year's show. The Mark Park hip hop royalty right here. It's another one, Project Globe anniversary. Lyricist Lounge anniversary, Freestyle Fellowship. So yeah, man, I've just been lucky and blessed to, you know, be able to contribute my own way, you know.
So you could say your love for photography, you kind of stumbled into it, or would you say it was you always had that?
I kind of always had it because my dad was a photographer. So when I was a kid, I would like load his film, go out on missions with him, help him. But then he stopped doing that. So I wasn't really into photography until like 2005, 2006, I got back into it. And then kind of just took off from there. Started selling my photos at different art places in Venice Beach and stuff like that. And then after that, I became a full-time artist pretty much. This is all I do, a hustle. Decided to turn my passion into like a job, you know?
Where we at today?
Bixby Knowles, Long Beach.
You know? Held what? How often is this?
Every first Friday.
First Friday of the month.
Cracking tonight. They got the fair going on outside and shit. This is me. This is my little space and shit.
You got a sale yet?
Yeah, I got one.
Nice. Yeah. What'd you sell?
Still early. A little can.
What'd they have on it?
Picture of the city.
No.
So I got a little bit of everything, you know what I'm saying?
What stood out the most or attracted you over when you walk over here?
Actually, his spray cans.
The spray cans.
The spray cans, and then taking a closer look to this particular one that had Cuidado. Mm-hmm. And then once that caught my eye, looking into all the intricate pieces and wording that he had on that one. And then actually, to be honest, just like, wow, there's a lot of work in that.
I get more sales in real life than on the internet, so That's why I'm always at different events, you know? Like my homeboy says, like, put it in their hand and shit, you know what I'm saying? Online, people can't really, like, hold your shit or, like, see it in real life. They get to see photos of it. But in person, it's, like, totally different, you know?
What's your favorite piece of his right here?
Oh, wow, that's a good question. I mean, I like this, like, honestly.
That one?
Yeah.
Why is that?
I mean, I just love the colors, and I mean, I think it is, like, really unique to, you know, just kind of, like, paint a spray bottle, in my opinion. Yeah, I don't know. I just haven't seen anything like it before, so that's probably why it's, like, one of my favorites.
Yeah, I used to eat before I get here. Drink snacks or like eat right after, but yeah, man, it's a grind, man. It's just like work. You gotta bring a lunch and shit. You know what I'm saying?
What do you do when you need to go somewhere? You have someone hold down the spot, someone next to you,
yeah,
next to the booth.
I usually just have like the neighbor hold me down and shit. You know what I'm saying? You gotta take breaks in there. It's like 4 hours just standing.
Yeah. It's a big standing job, right?
You see me, I got a wear chair. I stay busy and shit. I be making stuff.
Oh, you make stuff while you get in. Yeah. That's dope.
I gotta pass the time somehow.
When'd you take this photo?
6 years ago.
6 years ago?
Yeah. I took a bunch of photos that night. Like a downtown mission. Mm-hmm. Just bus missions. Just...
For those that don't know, what's a mission?
Just going out taking photos, you know? Yeah. Seeing what you can see. Yeah. Different angles and shit. I might go to the same place, but every time I go back, I try to take a different photo or hit it at a different angle and shit. You know what I'm saying? So it ain't redundant. Just try to be as creative as I can, you know? Like, as you can see and shit, like,
I got a little bit of everything.
When did you start that aspect of street vending?
2009, 2010. I really started hitting the boardwalk more and doing other shows like art walks and stuff like that. Especially downtown LA art walk, that shit used to be popping, but kind of died off after like gentrification and everything. But other than that, yeah, I've done shows at like galleries, fucking flea markets, pop up on the street somewhere, some random place. It's just a hustle like anything else. You gotta get in where you fit in, you know? So I keep my like little setup small.
So what's the biggest misconception you think people have about
They don't see the work that goes like behind the scenes. Like, I gotta find a spot, I gotta find parking, I gotta load up my cart, I gotta, you know, get my spot together, I gotta shoot the shit with people, then I gotta break down, do it all over again. So it's like, it ain't for everybody, you know what I'm saying? They really gotta be passionate about this shit. I see people dabble here and there, you know, then they fall off, or some people take it to another level. They got an art truck or doing other stuff. So, I mean, everybody's different, you know? But this is what works for me, you know? I'm known for this. Like, over the years, I met so many people that still fuck with me because I'm still doing the same thing, you know? Like, making authentic, original stuff, you know?
Someone might ask, why do street vending as opposed to trying to get your stuff into a store?
I cut the middleman out as much as I can. People be like, how come you're not in the gallery? Because they're taking 60 to 70% of my profit and I'm decorating their spot for free. I'm like, nah, I'd rather just sell it hand to hand, like dope, you know what I'm saying? Like, my art is dope, so I might as well just do a transaction with a real customer. Then decorate it somebody's spot or hang it on somebody's wall hoping it'll sell, you know what I'm saying? And then I still got to give them a cut when they didn't help me make it or anything, like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, I've been down that road. It ain't for everybody.
What will you never do art on? Is there any?
I can't say that. Shit, I sold Mr. Brainwash
a photo on a piece of cardboard.
You saw Mr. Brainwash?
Yeah, he bought some from me in Venice.
That's dope. That's dope.
It was like my weakest piece, I thought, and he loved it. He bought like two of them. I was like, all right, bro, hell yeah. I must be doing something right. Mr. Brainwash buying some shit off of me. You know what I'm saying?
That's dope.
Yeah, so like when other artists like appreciate your shit, that's like, you know you're doing something right.
That's the biggest accolade or trophy you could get?
Yep. Well, just the fact that like somebody buys your shit and then hangs it up in their house, that's crazy to me. It's like, that's the reason I do this, because like somebody sees something in you and then they see it in their house and it's like, make the connection, you know what I'm saying? Like, I did something right in the world, you know what I mean? Made somebody happy, or they connected with me through my art, you know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of people can't say that. A lot of people don't know why they're here. Like, they don't know their purpose. So, I'm lucky, like, I found my purpose out when I was still a little bit younger, so. Now it's just up to me to, like, carry it out more and spread it more, you know?
Yeah, I was gonna ask you if you had never found this creative medium to express yourself, what do you think you'd be doing, or where do you think you'd be if it wasn't for this influence of hip hop and art?
Shit, probably working some job I hate, like I used to. Straight up, like being like everybody else. Cause like, fuck, if you think about it, there ain't a whole lot of artists out there. Like, how many artists do you know off the back? Like, you know what I'm saying? So that makes you special, just doing that. Just doing something that's like not what like everybody else in society is doing, like, automatically makes you like a black sheep and shit, you know what I'm saying? So I don't care, I'll roll with that. I'll just do my different shit, you know? Everybody's put here to do something.